I'm Harry Clayton, this is my unit 21, and I'm doing about improving elderly provision at Riverside Leisure Centre. So gap being identified. So the group I'm targeting is obviously the elderly. The way I'm doing this is by getting them to go into leisure centres to do activities and be social with other people of the same age. So I'm going to put sessions on maybe once or twice a week for them to get involved in, which are going to last for 2 hours. So the following slide, you'll see what kind of sessions I'm going to be putting on in those, in the hour, and then what I'm going to, they're going to be doing in a social session. So the proposal summary. The reason why I'm doing this is because at an older age, older people tend to lose weight with some friends and then they don't have a lot to do during their time at home. So I'm basing this off an idea from CSM called Extra Time, where they get elderly people together and they do 1 hour of activities and then a second hour of social. Right, how to market this? So I'd market this not by social media, as not many other people are going to be on the internet or using social media, so I'll do it through TV adverts, radio adverts, newspapers, because they'd obviously be listening to these and watching these on a daily basis when they're at home. So the physical resources I'd require, obviously, a pool, because I'd be splitting up the hour into 3 20-minutes. So the first 20 then be doing walking in the pool. The second one then maybe use the studio for some circuitry, some light circuit training. And then the last one, they'd be doing some cycling or spin sessions in the cycling room at Riverside. This way they'd all be in separate groups and they'd be swapping for the whole hour, so they'd all be doing something at certain points. So the human resources that I need to run the session, I'd obviously do the first aider in case anything went wrong. I need one of those in every single session. Coaches to lead the spin classes, so make sure they're all doing it right, they don't need help with anything. And then with the aqua sessions, obviously need lifeguards and people on there to be able to show them what to do. And then for basic circuits, also the first aid in there, and someone to go through the circuit with them and help if they need anything, keep time for them. And then maybe just a member of staff, just to lead the session, just to float around and make sure everything's running smoothly, make sure they're all getting to the right sessions that they need to be at the right time, and making sure they're all 100% satisfied, don't need any help with anything more. So the operational considerations. The sessions will be running on a Wednesday and Thursday in the afternoon. Time is given the time to get up and actually get to the session for the afternoon. If it's early in the morning, they might get up early enough and might take them time to get there if they get a bus. Another operational consideration is that if one group is in a spin class and another one in the studio doing the circuit training, then you need to make sure that they're getting to their sessions on time and correctly. So you need a member of staff to go with them to swap them over, just to make sure they get there and back correctly so you can get going faster and get through everything. So the capital costs and start-up costs, they're not going to be too expensive, they're going to be more affordable, because if they're too expensive, they're not going to want to keep coming back and doing more sessions. So the capital cost, this is a one-off, one-time cost. When you turn up for a couple of hours, it'll be priced at £5. This will get you the activities in the first hour, and then in the second hour of social, where you have tea, coffee, and biscuits or something, just have a chat in one of the rooms for an hour. And then the start-up cost, this will be a start-up cost of £5, so the first time you attend, you'll need to have a sign-up fee and an admin fee, which you'll pay, and then you won't need to pay this again, because you've already paid it, so then you can attend the session.
Have you considered your marketing costs then? Radio is quite expensive, newspaper adverts, etc.
So the setting up price, obviously £5, the registration fee. The individual that's wanting to pay a fee for a month, so they can attend a total of 8 sessions in the month, is £30. This will give them access to 8 sessions, so obviously 2 a week. They can attend as many times as they want. If they attend all 8, then they'll be saving themselves obviously the first one that required a £10 registration fee. The fee that we'll be collecting will be going out to hire the rooms in Riverside and then pay for some staff. So obviously the studio is going to cost a paying a bit of the pool, and the spin room is going to be cost of this.
Well, some of it might just be fitting in with what they currently do. The times that you've picked, do they have stuff going on at that time?
So aims of aims and objective of improvement. So it's to aim to improve the amount of activity that elderly people get. They might sit at home all day watching TV. This way they can get out and be social with other people and get like do activities while doing it. The way I'd improve the session would maybe be to involve more activities, do longer sessions. So maybe do 2 20-minutes and a 20-minute break, and then another 2 sessions after. So add another 20-minute session in, and then maybe take down the social a bit more if they're not attending it for that long. So I'll do this by maybe like adding like a little time for them to go in the gym at Riverside to go on the treadmill, where they run or walk or anything like that, or do rowing. Another way to improve is to open up this sort of thing in another branch, saying like the David Lloyd Centre, so that people who are closer to David Lloyd could go there and do that for the 2 hours, or do it at the Norman Centre, so they'll all be able to access it really simply. But as if you start the sessions, I think it would improve their lifestyle. They'd get into more of a routine and not find themselves at home most of the day doing nothing and being bored just watching TV and being lonely. Specific, we have to make sure that the skills we're trying to teach them and the goals they want to achieve are relevant. So if they want to get better at swimming, then we're going to obviously target them more for going to the swimming. Or if they want to do cycling and maybe get out cycling on the paths or roads one day, then we're going to obviously make them want to do more cycling and put them in more spin classes, so they'll be able to develop their skills. Measurable, so we have to make sure the activity is measurable. So for example, if I'm doing a circuit, we can measure this by the amount of time it takes them to complete a certain circuit, or the amount of time, or how many times they do, say, a sit-up in the circuit at the start of the session, and then in 10 sessions' time we can do it again and see how they've improved, or if they've taken any benefits from this. And we have to make sure that all the tasks we're asking them to do are achievable. So obviously they're going to have to be a little bit challenging, but not too challenging to the point where they're going to struggle to even complete any of it. So an example of that is like in the circuit training, doing 5 sit-ups and not doing something like 15. Because if they're doing 15, they'll be able to do that and they're going to feel uncomfortable and not maybe want to get involved as much. So we've got to make sure that the activities we'll be doing are realistic. So obviously again by this, not make them do 20 push-ups, because they're not going to be able to do that at an old age. And even maybe some younger people struggle with it, so you've got to think about how that is best for their development and how they're going to react to it.
Can I just stop you there? I can see you've got a comprehension of the SMART targets. Assuming that I'm going to finance your scheme, I want to see targets for the scheme, not for the individuals that may come on your scheme. It will be, if I'm the money man, it's going to front the money to you just run your scheme. I want to see, what is your target number for people to attend? What might the growth number be? What's your break-even point? How many people do you need to make this program feasible? That's what your SMART target should revolve around. So we'll have to revisit that. Okay, well, move on to the next thing.
So SWOT analysis. So the strengths of putting on a session like this for the elderly, that gets them all together in groups, socialising, keep themselves fit as well while doing it. That's easier than just them maybe going out on a walk or something by themselves. This way they're getting to know people, helping their social skills. Also helps obviously to avoid getting lonely and leading on to other things like depression. And obviously, strengths like this will help with the actual leisure centre themselves, because because they're going to attract more people into their leisure centre, and then the owner might want to buy a membership at the end of it or during it to go up a day that they enjoy it, and go in maybe more swimming pool sessions or anything like that without all the people. They could be more social this way. Weaknesses, there are not many weaknesses to what if getting put ahead at all. One weakness I say there would be is that maybe the rooms of leisure might not always be in use, and this way we'd have to change the plan and do something else for that. We'll make sure that they've been booked out at a specific time, and if the pool can't be booked out specifically, just a group of people, we'll have to just go about it how it comes. Because if it gets slightly crowded in the pool, then that's not going to be easy to do a session in. So opportunities. The opportunities for other people. So one example is CSF. They have a club called Extra Time. Well, they take the time and approach to get good members turn out and run a good session. So like this could help promote the leisure centre, obviously, with loads of people coming in. They're going to see that they cover all types of target groups, and they're going to want to think, I'll go to Riverside, because you know they have everything. They have something for everyone there. Whether you are a mother and toddler or an elderly person, you can all get involved there. So they've got a session on for everyone, so everyone can get involved. With the timescales, so I start to promote a month before the actual sessions commence. This gives them time to see the adverts, hear the adverts on the radio or see them in the newspaper. And this way they can get themselves signed up or maybe contact us in a way to say that they'd want to come down and ask any information about it. Review dates. So after they've attended a month of sessions, so maybe a couple 8 sessions, I'll take this opportunity to give them a questionnaire where they're to how likely they are to recommend to a friend, if they enjoy it and what they'd improve. And if they have anything to improve, then we'll take these ideas into consideration and try and improve the session better. So if that be opened up in more leisure centres that's more easily accessible, then that's something you'd have to take into consideration. And also on the review day, we'll share with the participants some of the scores. So say they've been scoring in circuit training and doing a whole circuit in 5 minutes at the start, and they're now doing it in 4, we'd inform them that they've improved in that. And just go through all other types of scores with them, like doing a spin class, how long they've been on the bike for, and if they've beat their hurdles.
With what you're proposing, what makes you think this is actually going to work?
Is any other schemes like this running around anywhere?
Yeah, the CSF Extra Time, which take the same sort of approach. So they do a couple of hours, they get all people together. And a lot of people.
Does that revolve around football then?
Probably, yeah.
Probably.
Yeah.
So you don't know.
No. But
what's going to make you think then older people are going to go, oh, we've got a multi-activity exercise orientated program and I'll come and spend money at that?
Because it's going to be advertised in a way that it's not just about doing the activities, it's about getting up together, having a good time, getting exercise in a good quality leisure centre, meeting new people, and maybe, you know, going on to get the proper membership in the long run, which will help the gym out. And if you're sitting at home and you have nothing to do and you're bored, then you're gonna think for a decent price I can go there and get active and have a good time with new people, meet new people along the way.
Would you say a threat to this program then would be CSF's
Extra Time then?
Yeah, it could be, but if then again the elderly people don't want exactly play football all the time. Then they're gonna, and they want to do maybe get in the pool for a bit, which is nice and easy for them just to move around in or get on a bike for a little bit. And this is open to them.
Assuming that CSF is actually just a football-based thing, Extra Time. Okay, we'll move on.
So with milestones, 10 weeks into the session, there'll be maybe promotions, so like a double up, you can bring a friend. They can attend the session for free, just for the one time. This will hopefully attract a bigger crowd where they'll think, yeah, I enjoyed that, I'll come back and pay again. I'll pay again and come weekly with him, and then we'll make more. It's just more of a social, and the second bit they enjoy, and they can come for that. After 20 weeks, we'll have a big review day. This will be where the whole 2 hours will be with the teas and coffees and going through as a group where you've improved in, say, you're on the bike for 5 minutes and got tired the first session, now 20 weeks along, you're doing it for 15. So you can see where you've improved and if you've developed your skills in any way, so say in the circuit training, you've done a few extra press-ups over the course of those 20 weeks. And in this way, you can all, it can maybe be like a little challenge, things like they'll compete against each other. Say like I did more press-ups than you, and then the next review day they'll push themselves maybe further to try and see so they can be the other person. Responsibilities for implementation, so there'll be many staff members. Each member of staff will be given a different responsibility. For example, maybe a receptionist that floats around signing people in, or signing people up if they haven't been before. There'll be other staff members, so personal trainers for the circuit training, because they'll probably need all the support they can get in there, and there's no one better to know how to do stuff correctly than a personal trainer. So they'll lead the activities like the swimming, the spin classes, and the circuit training. There'll be a sort of a manager in charge of the whole project that'll be floating around, making sure everything's running smoothly, asking people if they're enjoying this, and if they're not, then they can move on to another group or change up what they're doing if they don't enjoy so much of the pool. There'll be a few volunteers that come along. This could help them with their CVs, doing volunteering hours out of any of their time. So they could help with the social hour, pouring the teas out, and this will look good for them in the long run when they get a job. And maybe even get a job doing stuff with this session. So my KPIs, but even figures. So I'll be using figures to see how many people have turned up and comparing this from the first session to then the 2-for-1 where two people, where they bring a friend, and then see if after that there's more people turned up. So we'll be comparing all the time and making sure that it's actually worth our time going there, to making sure that everyone's turning up and everyone's getting involved.
What's the target number for participants?
I was going to base that off the first session that goes there. If there's like a decent amount of, like, say, it'd be best to have 15 if you need one of the three groups. So I would say about 45 at the start with, and then after 45, depending on if there's many more people turn up after the when they bring a friend, then that'd be bumped up to around 60-ish, and we could split the groups into 20-20-20. But anything lower than 15 per group would be seen as underachieving. So
45 people turning up per each week for this session?
Yeah.
Okay.
This would make it, like, so if 15 people in each group, there's enough to cover each group to make it worthwhile for the individual personal trainer.
What does CSF do? What sort of participation do they get for their extra time session?
Varies, really.
From what to what? Don't speculate. We'll move on.
Another way I'll measure is by giving out also questionnaires to all of the people involved. So they can have one of each specific session, say the swimming session, how they enjoyed it, if they'd rather do something else, and if so, what. So say they don't want to keep in and out of the pool every session, then they could maybe swap that with going into the actual gym for 20 minutes.
Okay.
If there's a big amount that they want to do something, it might get a bit of tedious, keep popping in and out of the pool for a little amount of time. And if they're just getting in and then getting out again, and they don't want to still wet or something, then that's something you'd have to take into consideration. Other questionnaires would be like how they'd improve the flow. So would they rather do an hour and a half of activities and half an hour of the social, so they can, and then score on how likely they are to recommend to a friend, and if they want to recommend to a friend.
Okay.
So yeah,
okay. I'll stop it there.